is going on, everyone? Welcome to my channel. My name is gyasilinje. For those of you all who are new here, welcome. I like to make tech and lifestyle videos. I also am a full-time software developer, so a good chunk of my videos are about that as well. And for those of you all who have been here before and have been following me the past couple months, you know that I've been testing out a couple different laptops, the 16-inch MacBook Pro and now the Dell XPS. You're probably wondering, why did I get an iMac? I want to give a special shout out to our sponsor today, Clean My Mac X, for sponsoring this video. I'm heavily invested in the Mac ecosystem, and for the foreseeable future, I plan on staying that way. I have an Apple Watch, an iPhone. I don't have an iPad Pro right now, but that is something that I plan on investing in the future, especially now in that the iPad OS is getting a lot more powerful and it's almost like a full-blown laptop at this point. The iMac I decided to purchase is the base model 5K 27-inch. This iMac comes packed with a 3.0 gigahertz 6-core i5 8th gen processor with turbo boost up to 4.1 gigahertz, 8 gigs of RAM, 1 terabyte Fusion drive that I do plan on upgrading to SSD in the future, and 4 gigs of Radeon Pro 570X graphics. This 2-in-1 desktop also has a beautiful 5K display that I'll talk about later on in the video. I did miss being able to airdrop assets and things that I needed for my YouTube videos from like my phone to my laptop and from my laptop to my phone. That's something that you really don't think about until you can't airdrop anymore and how convenient it is. Another thing is that I do miss using Mac OS. Don't get me wrong, I don't miss Finder at all by any means, but there are some quirky things that I've been having to do with the Dell XPS that I'm not used to doing that I feel like I shouldn't need to do for a laptop that's north of $1,000. And the purpose of this video is to not compare the Dell XPS 15 to this iMac by any means. It's just a natural thing to compare your old or existing tech with the new tech that you're using. So my software development and design experience is desktop and web focused. However, mobile iOS development, native iOS development at that, has always excited me the most. I got a little bit of that experience using Swift and Xcode when I was a senior in college, but haven't been able to since because one, the laptop I had just wasn't powerful enough to run Xcode efficiently. But now with an iMac, I have the ability to gain those skill sets in mobile development. With the iMac, not only can I do content creation, but I also can efficiently and effectively do some mobile app development. The display was a major factor for this purchase. As a full-time software developer and YouTuber, I greatly appreciate having colorful displays that are accurate for video editing and large enough to multitask while programming. With 1 billion colors and 500 nits of brightness, the Retina P3 color gamut fills the screen with spectacular color. But before we continue to talk about why I chose to get an iMac, I want to show you how Clean My Mac X can help maximize your Mac. When you first open the app, you're going to notice that it's probably the best user experience you have ever seen in a utilities app. The first thing Clean My Mac X does is scan your hardware for any unneeded junk, such as unnecessary files that are being used. As you can see, I only have 536 megabytes of unnecessary junk, but you can imagine how many large unused files are on a computer that someone's been using for an extended period of time without cleaning their Mac on a consistent basis. Although most of the unneeded files in my Mac are cache files, I wouldn't have even thought that these cache files could take up so much space so quickly. Clean My Mac X also checks for and fights any malware, ransomware, adware, and all the other wares specific to macOS. When an issue is detected, the app delegates it right away. They regularly update their malware database, and Clean My Mac X's protection module always has your back. Another feature that I find so helpful is the duo of uninstaller and updater. Clean My Mac X provides an easy way to remove any of those unneeded installers and apps you don't use and allows you to update all your software. Those are some things Clean My Mac X did for my system. You can see what it can do for your system by clicking the link below. They have a free trial, so you can give it a try. If you want to buy an annual membership or make a one-time purchase to use Clean My Mac X forever, be sure to use promo code GL10OFF for 10% off Clean My Mac X license for a subscription or one-time payment. You can get 1, 2, or 5 licenses, which I think is a great deal to maximize and protect your system. Thanks again to Claim My Mac X for sponsoring this video. I've wanted a dedicated desktop computer for a while, and to be honest, I never even considered a PC, but I've always had my eyes on the iMac because it seamlessly works with other Apple devices like the iPhone, so I can stay connected with friends and family while staying focused on my work. The 2-in-1 desktop is where it all started, with color grading and video editing. Getting my first 1,000 view video that was edited on this computer. So you can say there's a special connection between the iMac and I. Outside of having dedicated graphics and a lot of storage, I decided to get the iMac because of all the things it has that the MacBook lacks, starting with the price based off the specs you get. A multitude of ports I can easily connect other computers and devices to, 4 USB 3 ports plus 2 Thunderbolt 3 USB-C ports, an SD card slot, which is something you can't take for granted, being able to easily input an SD card for video editing and file exchange. The iMac is also upgradable, which was another reason that sold me on this computer, so I'm glad I waited for the latest version. You pair the custom upgrades with a 5K display, an operating system that is reliable and works seamlessly with other devices you use all the time, you have yourself a pretty future-proof machine. All right, so with that being said, that concludes this video. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it at all. Comment down below some of your thoughts. Also, if you're interested in learning more about the iMac and how I use it, or my desk setup, comment down below, or give this video a thumbs up. Share it with someone who you think might benefit from it. And as always, have a blessed rest of your week, and I'm praying that your family and friends are staying safe and healthy. I'll see you all soon. Peace.